Hi there, I'm Dr. Ashwini GB. I'm a fertility specialist and an IVF consultant. I head the IVF program at Aspire Fertility Center, HSR Layout, Bangalore. Pelvic inflammatory disease and polycystic ovarian syndrome are two different diseases without any relationships as such. They have totally different etiopathology, and pelvic inflammatory disease itself is an infection, whereas polycystic ovarian disease is not. Pelvic inflammatory disease, or PID, what we commonly call it, happens because as a complication of sexually transmitted infections. This is an infection of the uterus, the fallopian tubes, and the ovaries. This infection is easily treatable with antibiotics. The decision as to whether to admit a person or to treat on an OPD basis will depend on how serious the situation is. Most of the pelvic inflammatory diseases, or PIDs, get controlled with oral antibiotics. The indications for admissions could be like when the disease is not responding to antibiotics, or when it is in association with an abscess, or the patient is unable to tolerate an oral antibiotic therapy. And also, when PID occurs with pregnancy, this calls for an admission. When it is confusing and we can't rule out a surgical complication like appendicitis, then also admission is advisable. Whereas polycystic ovarian syndrome happens as a genetic cause, wherein a person may not be ovulating, due to which the cycles become irregular. Now, coming back to pelvic inflammatory disease, once treated, the pelvic inflammatory disease can cause long-term effects due to scarring of the fallopian tubes. This in turn can lead to ectopic pregnancies, in turn can lead to infertility and chronic pelvic pain. So it's very important to prevent, and even if there is PID, to treat it early. Polycystic ovarian disease, in contrast, happens because of anovulation. Yes, PCOD itself is also associated with infertility, but however, PCOD itself does not lead to PID, neither PID leads to polycystic ovarian syndrome.